But let's talk about the slide. You said, okay, not a clean slide. Was the retaliation a little bit too much on the part of Kelly? Why didn't they just take care of things at the time?
Well, this is the first series against the Red Sox and Yankees, so you have to establish yourself. And I think it's important to note that Aaron Boone and also Alex Cora are the first-year managers. They have to set a precedence. Right. And this is a big situation for both sides. But last night, the Yankees losing 14-1, maybe a little bit of embarrassment. They want to set a tone. I think this was dirty, and the retaliation was because this is a dirty slide. And to your point, Chris, this would happen to Dustin Pedroia last year. So you have to handle the situation, in my opinion.
The slide was late. He's lucky he didn't hurt himself. And as an opposing team, we don't want to address anybody but the person that did that. And I thought it was just.
So that's why Joe Kelly waited, yes. Wanted to see whoever the pitcher was. They were going to go after Tyler Austin when he came up.
Kelly was in that bullpen spewing, and he wanted to be in that situation.
Now, does that come from the bench? Does a manager, somebody kind of...
It depends what kind of guy you are. It comes from me. I, every time I hit somebody on purpose, it came from me because I want to defend my guys, and you don't want to lose guys in your locker room, and that's the reason why you make that purpose and send that message that you can't do that to our guys.
Train, I totally agree. It galvanizes a club. And you think about both of these teams, it's kind of strong-arming the situation here. Who is going to start balking on this? The Yankees have struggled early in the year this year, and that's why the Red Sox have to maintain that as well. You protect your own. Obviously, being the home team, the emotion of the crowd, that comes into it as well. But you think about it, they have 17 more matchups.
Right.
And this is going to get very interesting.
Yeah, the Red Sox going for their 10th straight win in this game, in this series, including postseason, 2,196 meetings, including this one. And even though these are young players, they know the history of the Yankees and Red Sox. They want to live up to their side of things.
And you're on the field, so you're feeling the intensity and the pride. And
again, look at Kelly.
And everyone's watching this tape. After the game, they go back in, and everyone sees who was out there, who has their back. That's like, I got your back, Sweeney, dog. And you take pride in that, and you want to be around guys that will run through a wall, and the guys will never forget about Kelly doing that, protecting your part.
You think about, too, maybe a meeting after, hey, guys, we have to do this. You did a good job protecting your own. But now this, these 17 more meetings, it starts tomorrow. It's going to be pretty interesting to see how this evolves and who has the upper hand and who definitely knows that they did the right thing tonight.
Yeah. So who's guilty of starting this, and was there an overreaction in the retaliation?
Well, it really started last night, and it was a 3-run home run by Hunter Renfroe, and then Manny Margot takes his at-bat in the ninth inning.
So he triggers this.
He 2-1 count. He's trying to lay a bunt down. In my opinion, he needs to swing a bat. You're at Coors Field. The next pitch, 95 on the ribcage. I understand he's apologizing, but this is a scenario that maybe he took it upon himself to say, I didn't need to see you lay a bunt down. Right. It's that competitive balance. That's what it really happens.
Especially the type of ball player that Margot is. They expect him to swing the bat. It's emotional. The Rockies just gave up the lead. 3-run bomb in the ninth. So everybody's emotional. But again, if I'm seeing him at the plate bunting, I'm going to be upset, especially the situation of the ball game.
And the umpires said there were no warnings given, until afterwards. So they thought they had things under control until Arenado was struck and charged the mound, and then this ensued. And I know during this, Mark, it struck you as interesting. Look at the throw with the glove.
He missed him with the ball and the glove. He was 0-2.
and he's running. Perdomo is on the move.
He saw a bull in his eyes, though. He saw that energy in his eyes.
About,
said, help me. Get him off me. Get him off me.
McGuire trying to retain or at least control. Talk to Arenado.
Well, Mark McGuire, the bench coach of the Padres, understands this scenario so well because he was the type of player that ended up getting thrown at it back in his day. He also has a connection with Nolan Arenado. He's trying to be the peacekeeper here and also saying how many guys got thrown at, and you're the best player in the game. You almost have to expect it because I think Nolan Arenado didn't believe he should have been thrown at. It should have been somebody else. Well, that's what happens in these scenarios to try to take control of it. You guys know they've played seven times already this season. The next road trip, the Padres go back and play another series in Colorado. So this is going to get interesting moving forward. Obviously, there's going to be expectations, and the umpires are going to take control of the situation.
Yeah, later we'll talk about possible suspensions, what we think. But the player's code, whether a young guy, a veteran, you should know this. You should understand this when you're out on the field, whether you're the pitcher or the hitter.
And that's what McGuire was trying to explain to Arenado, that three of our guys got hit. Calm down. You should expect this also because you're the face of this franchise and you're the face of this ball club. But that energy, let's see how they react. You saw the error when they intensified. side. So let's see if the Padres can to stay up there and battle this team, because they're going to be division rivals. And it's going to be exciting. It's going to be postseason baseball in Colorado and San Diego between these two teams next time they face.
Well, April's getting interesting.
Yeah, it's going to be fun.
Five ejections in that Rocky Padre.
Before you go, first of all, I know I'm not a hair guy, but Bryce Harper is. We saw that, which was pretty important. And you see him with the double blow dryers.
Right. We double
were wondering what you would do, Chris. I mean, you see it. Is that something you're?
Yeah. Oh no!
No, wait a minute. Look, no, you know what? Dontrelle. Got me. That is not cool.
And that's beautiful form right there.
No, right?
That is beautiful form. Right there. Nice. With the slick back all ready to go.
That was Dontrelle. That was your bug spray. You're
the best, General.
This looks
I
like
love the elbow, the slow motion right here. You all right with me, General. I love it.
How long is he staying?
Come on, baby. He set you up.
You're going to see a brawl right here. Don't rub the hair.
No, we don't touch the hair.
Don't mess the
hair. I want to keep my job. You don't touch General hair. You don't want to touch General hair.
And for Mark Sweeney, our entire crew, I'm Chris Myers. How's the hair like?
Looking good.
Thanks for watching.
It's holding on.
Whip around tomorrow night with these guys, 11 Eastern.